Okay, guys, welcome. I hope everyone is doing well. I am certainly doing pretty okay. Today we have something rather interesting and special. So I figured, you know what? Let's just start with the die calendar first and see what we have beer-wise after we move on. So there we go. We have door number 10. Let's see if I can find it. There it is. And oh, it's the same Christmas-themed one we had before, but then in D6. Yeah. Look, there's a five upside down. That's the five. There's the three. And instead of a six, because here's the four. Instead of a six, there is a little gift. Nice Christmas themed D6. Cool. So, beer wise, what do you got? Well, we got something interesting. Today, our beer situation comes from Tiny Rebel. Bread and gas are, as you can probably imagine from their names, from the UK. And again, from the UK. Lots of beer from the UK this year. But yeah, they are the only brewer ever from Wales that's been called the best brewer from the UK. Ever. And I think I had some beer from them before, and I think they're pretty good. Probably because otherwise it wouldn't be best beer of the UK, right? Let's just see what we got here. We got here more money. More problems. Or in other words, we got two beers. Yeah. And what I'm supposed to do with two beers? Well, not just drink them. I'm supposed to mix them. So, mixing beers is not new. Actually, aside from of course mixing things with like tea or herbs, of course. Mixing beers it's been done as long as the 19th century. For example, with young porters and old porters to make like a more of a ripe beer. Same with lambic beers. They've been doing that too, with younger and old lambics. And so yeah, mixing beers. So for example, to like create different taste is nothing new. But now we get to do it ourselves, which is something that is pretty cool. So we have two beers, right? The first beer, Mo Money, is a beer, a wheat beer based on pomegranate. It's this. We're supposed to be smelling the sweetness of elderflower with aromas of pineapple. A sparkling beer with a silky taste at the end. The pomegranate are supposed to be giving a distinctive sweetness with the sour of the wheat. So let's just see what we got here. Let's put this in the extra glass already. So, there's more money. I do smell some flowery stuff and some fruity stuff. I don't know elderflower, so But the taste is great. There was some taste coming through my nose, but not in a bad way. It has a really sweet taste, and yeah, it has a hint of sour, but not too much. So that's cool. And then we got more problems. And more problems is a wheat-based IPA. Like IPAs a lot. And the hop brings a abundant dose of passion fruit with lemon. The beer. I'm sorry, I'm still enjoying this for the first one. The beer is light with a sweet passion fruit, with sweet passion fruit and a more present bitterness of than the Mo Money. So here we go. Go for the Mo Problems. Oh, I definitely smell some lemon. There we go. Fits in the glass a lot better than the first one, strange enough, but there we go. There's some lemon floating in there. Oh yeah, definitely smell the lemon. No, there we go. Yeah, this is a more Ooh. I guess that's the passion fruit. Oh my God, this is also pretty good. It's definitely a bit more bitter. But that sweetness is oh great. So yeah. Those are the two beers independently. Really enjoyable, but now, with a little bit of beer from the first for the first one, let's just see if we can mix it up equally and see if we can get a completely different taste. So there we go. I feel like a fucking chemist. Never did anything with chemistry, so. Just mix the leftovers from these here, too. So. Okay. I don't really smell anything special. I smell all kinds of fruits, so let's just go ahead and You know what? It's interesting. But honestly, I like them independently a lot more than. Yeah. Yeah, well, they independently they had like really interesting flavors that were like all over my mouth and even through my nose. This one is just, eh? I guess. According to the description, the malt money is going to balance with the bitter hops of the malt problems, I guess, but that's kind of one of my issues with it. The home remains tropical, sort of, with a more contrasting presence of pomegranate, I guess. In the mouth, the silky texture of malt money is preserved, yeah, but the whole is less sour. Again, too bad because I kind of like that sourness. The newly crafted beer is a more effervescent and is more effervescent and spicy with more sweetness. Nah, I just know. The effect is fascinating. Well, that is true. So yeah, I'm a little bit disappointed, to be honest. Let's see if the shape of the glass has a little bit more of an effect. I guess I get a little bit more taste, but no, not really. So yeah, I'm a little bit disappointed. Individually, they were great, but together, I don't know. I can take it or leave it. But it was interesting to do one day. So you know, sometimes you need to fail to find out what you like, right? So, after this way longer video than normal, I'm gonna wish you guys a wonderful day or night, and I see you guys next time with hopefully just a good beer and no experimenting. So yeah, see you guys later. Bye.